on it. This is Superfan versus Superfan,
Black Mirror edition.
Hello and welcome here to the windy city of San Francisco. I'm Munya Chawawa, here to take two Netflix superfans through a whirlwind of blustery challenges and gale force knowledge. But how does it work?
Well, I'm glad you asked, Munya. Our Netflix superfans go head to head answering questions about their favorite Netflix shows from these living rooms. And if they get a question right, they move up this board, slowly edging their way towards ultimate superfandom. But they won't just be battling against each other. Oh no. Each superfan has also to withstand these superfans. How powerful are they? Well, they begin at a blustery 20 miles per hour, but every three questions a superfan gets right will increase their opponent's fan speed until it reaches 100 miles per hour. But what happens when it reaches 100 miles per hour? Well then, that superfan will get super flanned. Oh, right, okay.
Today we nosedive into the dystopian nightmare that is Black Mirror to find out who has come here with the brains of a true superfan and who has mere artificial intelligence. Let's meet the superfans.
Originally from Italy and Cameroon, Georgia is a film student living in London. When Georgia's not watching her favourite episode, Nosedive, she likes to play volleyball and make and edit videos. She once flew a kite and had a lovely time.
I might be a film student, but it's Luke that's going to be gone with the wind.
Luke is a supermarket customer assistant living in London. Hobbies include skateboarding and football, and he's been known to skip social occasions that clash with the new Black Mirror episodes. The winniest place he's ever been is Busson in France.
I'm a football fan, and I'm going to blow the competition away. Just call me Hurricane.
Black Mirror, mirror on the wall, who's the biggest super fan of all? Let's find out. Ready? Steady. Blow. Fingers on buzzers as we jump into question number one. Rachel, Jack, and which other name feature in the title of a season 5 Black Mirror episode? George coming in hot.
Ashley.
Is the correct answer. What do soldiers in Men Against Fire think they're hunting?
Roaches.
Is the correct answer, my friend. Which episode shares its name with a large reptile?
Crocodile.
Snapped that one up, didn't he? It is indeed Crocodile. What is the name of the restaurant? Kenny works.
Barney's.
Absolutely right, which means we are neck and neck going into the next question. What is the name of the CEO?
Billy Bauer.
Correct. And you must be feeling like a bit of a silly Billy, Luke, because your fan is about to get cranked. How's that feeling?
That's still quite nice, to be fair. I like that.
You're quite a warm-blooded man, aren't you? That's what they say about you and in the streets.
Yeah.
We all know that Bandersnatch revolutionised interactive streaming content, but what I really want to know is, can you find a pair of identical pandas on these cars? Fangers on buzzers, it's time for Bandersnatch Panda Match. Let's see the first panda match. It's tense at the moment, just getting their bearings. Luke, that is the correct match, and I'm afraid, Georgia, things are about to get rather grisly, because your fan is getting cracked. Up next is the panda from the Sooty Show. Do we have the license? No. Sue me. Luke, very, very good indeed. That is correct. Back to quizness. The name of what city is on the back of Danny's jacket in the opening scene of Striking Vipers? Okay, Luke, I was going to give you a clue, but you don't need one.
Chicago.
Oh, mate. I mean, look, to be honest, they're right next to each other. It's Tokyo.
Oh.
And now it's time for the true or false round. I'm going to tell you something about the show, and you just need to tell me whether it's science fact or science fiction. Hated in the Nation is the longest non-interactive episode of Black Mirror.
Science fact.
In Metalhead, the robots are referred to as cats.
Science fiction.
It is indeed science fiction. They are dogs. Now, Black Mirror has had many star cameos over the years, and we're going to load them onto the control panel of the USS Callister. Fastest fingers to guess whose face is loading wins himself a point in a game we call USS Callistars. Fingers on buzzers, let's load in the first picture. Yes, Georgia.
Miley Cyrus.
Georgia, you are miles ahead, and unfortunately, Luke, I'm going to have to come in like a wrecking ball and crank up that fan. Oh, I can see him starting to sweat, or rather I can see that sweat being blown away. Let's go into another one now. Load her up.
Bryce Dallas Howard.
And Luke, the Bryce was right for you because Georgia, your fan's now getting cranked. Goodness me, neck and neck again. This is tense. My bottom's certainly clenching. Science fact or science fiction? The title of the episode, Hang the DJ, is a ref...
Science fact.
At the beginning of Nosedive, Lacey is practicing crying in the... Luke.
Science fact.
Nope.
It is science fiction and an evil laugh coming from the corner of Georgia there. He was actually laughing. But you may be crying in the mirror if you get another one of those wrong. It's time for another round of Bandersnatch Panda Match. Let's see if you can match this. It's a picture of a panda holding Amanda Holden. Incredible scenes coming from Luke's corner. Let's see if you can match these two. Goodness me, it is pandemonium in the studio at the moment. That point means I'm gonna have to crank Luke's fan up another notch. So, Luke out. You're a man of few emotions, I've realised.
A lot of people say that, yeah. I've been compared to various serial killers over the years.
So. Oh, well, that's good to know. Right, back to quizness. In playtest, what gaming company runs the...
Saito Gamu.
Which I thought was the name of a Pokemon. Right, now, in Black Museum, at what specific time of the day do tours begin according to the sign on the door? Luke.
11 a.m.
Guys, we are neck and neck again. I guess you could say your scores are a mirror image. Since Luke whirlwinded that point, Georgia, I'm gonna have to crank up the fan. Right, now, back to quizness. Which episode is entirely... Hang on, Luke, you can't possibly know what I'm about to say.
Yeah, I've just got a premonition.
Okay, go on.
Which episode is entirely in black and white?
Okay, and what was it?
Metalhead.
What's going on here? That is the correct answer, my friend. Well done.
Whoa. All
right. What is the name of the arch enemy of USS Callis? Yes, Georgia.
Bad luck.
Which season 4 episode starts with a cesarean section?
Archangel!
What happened now? Right.
Archangel.
This is a tricky one.
Just give him a point anyway.
Georgia, I'm gonna give you the point. Okay, now, what is the dating device called in Hang the DJ? Yes, Georgia.
Coach.
And you can't coach talent like that. Luke, I'm afraid it's about to get breezier on the knees here. Gonna crank up your fan. Right now, time for some more USS Callis stars.
Michaela Cole.
Yes, indeed. Here's another.
John Hamm.
That is the correct answer. Now, back to quizness. What year is the beginning of San Junipero set in?
1987.
The man, you're blowing me away with your skills here. And this weather report just in, it's about to get a whole lot windier in Georgia. I've got to crank up the fan. F-Loop. Tell me this, what is the name of the smithereens employee who is in charge of Jaden? Yes.
Hannah Kent.
And another point on the board for you there, Georgia.
Amazing.
Time for more science fact or science fiction. In Rachel, Jack and Ashley 2, Kevin's company deals with mice.
Science fact.
That was indeed a fact, which means, Luke, you're in a whirlwind of trouble. It's time to crack the fan. So, Georgia, you now need 3 to win. Luke, you need 6. And it's another round of Bandersnatch Panda Match. Here we go. Try and match these two pandas. Very nice indeed, my friend. Here's another. This one is of a panda pot. Yes, Georgia, which now brings you within 2 measly points of scoring the win. Time for another science fact or science fiction. Kenny's sister is called Lindsay.
Science fact.
Luke, you're gonna have to speak up and buzz if you want any chance of keeping a flan-free face, my friend. This is for the win, match point.
Come on.
In Black Museum, where does Nish tell Rolo she flew into? Luke.
Cape Town.
buddy. It was Salt Lake City. Luke, it's going all the way up, my friend. Which means, Georgia, you are the winner. Now, we can all break wins. Oh, finally, I've been holding that in all episodes. Well, Georgia, you raced ahead and left Luke in your rearview mirror. Now you win the coveted Superfan versus Superfan Superfan. Begin the Superfan Pair!
Ooh!
Which unfortunately means that you, Luke, are a total airhead. Your mirror reality was shattered, and on reflection, perhaps you weren't quite ready for today's challenge. So, before Luke Skywalker becomes Flan Solo, any last words?
I'd just like to apologise to all the fans I've let down.
You mean all the flans? Hit it! Listen, I can't see much of Luke's face, but I can still tell he is completely emotionless. Luke, how are you doing?
I can't see you, but yeah.
Well, from high tech to pie tech in no time at all, two contestants threw caution to the wind, but there can only be one true superfan who takes home the Charlie Brooker Prize. That's it for the Black Mirror edition. We'll see you soon again for the next Superfan versus Superfan, and thanks for watching. Bye-bye now. Get to like this video and follow us for more. Bye-bye. Heatwave.